Hey everyone, it's Dale here again from Crazy Good PowerPoint. During the Google I.O. keynote last week, they had a really good text animation as they introduced each section of their presentation. So I thought I'd recreate this in PowerPoint and then show you how it's done. You can use this as a video intro or to introduce new sections in your presentation. It's up to you. Let's get going. Alright, so in this slide animation, there are three key sections. So the first thing we're going to do is bring in this awesome text. And then we'll come straight to this next slide and we'll have this text move to the left. And for the very last slide, we'll just do a morph which ends up in the middle. So we'll come over and we'll start fresh with a brand new slide. So first thing we'll do is come in and insert the text box. And we'll just make it the full width of the slide. And I'll type in awesome. Now I've already set this as a default text box, and you can do that. If you right click a text box and you set default text box, then whatever settings that you had will remain there whenever you insert new ones. So in this case, I've got Montserrat semi-bold, I've got the font set to 115, and I've got the color set to black. Beautiful. Next, I'm going to right click the background and go to format background, and we're going to change the color to the same color that Google used, which is the Google blue. Now I have that saved here, and I've got the color code on screen for you to use as well if you'd like. Next, we're going to duplicate this text. So I'll click on it, and whilst holding down Control Shift, I'm just going to click and drag it up and I'll get another version of that text. Because one of these is going to be a solid text and the other one's going to have an outline effect. So let's see how that's done. I'll go over here and open the selection pane, because in a moment we're going to rename these as one has been outline and one will be solid. So this one on top, we're going to leave solid because we want that to appear above the outline. So on the second one, which we can see is on the bottom, we're going to come to text options. In this case, where it says no fill, just click on solid fill and then back to no fill again. Just one of those little quirks of PowerPoint. And then come down to text outline and select solid line. And we'll choose black. And increase the width to 1 point. Perfect. Now whilst holding down Shift, select both text boxes, and now we're going to add the animation we want. So go to the Animation tab, and we'll click the Appear animation. Now this animation might seem a bit boring for now, but what we're going to do is animate each letter one by one. So to do that, we'll go to the Animation pane, and you'll see our option here. Click this drop down, we'll start this with Previous, and we'll click the drop down again and come to Effect Options. And where we'll see animate text, we'll change this to by letter. And to speed things up a bit, we'll change this to 0.1 seconds. Perfect. Now we want the outline text to animate first and then the black text to come in afterwards. So we just need to delay this a little bit. So what we'll do to make it easy to identify is we'll select this text box. Let's rename it now. Now over here I can see we've got our solid and outline. And I want the solid to come in after the outline. So I'll click it here and I'll drag it down below, hover over, and we'll just drag this across until we delay the start by 0.3 seconds. If I click play all, you'll see that there's a bit of a delay between the two, which looks great. Let's select both text boxes. Come to our align tool. We'll select align to slide. And then we'll align them to the middle of the slide. And now they're perfect. Let's try that again. Beautiful. Now we'll want this text to actually come in on a motion path. So push Ctrl A to select both. When adding more effects, be very careful not to come into the animation here again because you'll just change what you've already selected. Instead, what we want to do is come to Add Animation. And we'll choose the motion path. Now in this case, it's moving down. So come to Effect Options and we're going to reverse the path direction. We also want to speed this up a bit, so we'll change the duration to 1 second. We'll set this to start with previous. And what we'll do, we'll also go to the effects options, and we want to give this a smooth start only, and actually have an abrupt ending to it. Click OK. And what we want to do is have this animation start with the very first animation. So let's try that now. Fantastic. That's our first slide done. To create the next slide, come to the first slide and we'll right click and we'll duplicate it. Come to animation pane and we'll delete out all of the animations. We'll drag this text out of the way because in the second slide we don't need the underline for the text one. What we'll do is rename this one to be our text two outline. And we'll come in here and we'll just type in slide intro. Now push Ctrl D to duplicate this, and I'll just drag it down a little bit. And I want this one to be solid, so click on this text box, go to Home, Format Painter, and we'll paint that format onto this slide intro. Now hold down Ctrl A, select all, and we're going to increase the font size in this case to 190. Just going to zoom out a bit, and you'll notice here that this E from the Awesome is cut down. So let's just make these a bit wider. So hold down Control and drag it to the right and it'll actually resize it equally on both sides. Perfect. I'll now realign the slide intro with the first slide intro text and we'll move these into position. That's looking great, but we want the text to actually be positioned where the slide's going to end its animation. And that way it's ready to morph into the next slide. So we'll select both of these and we're just going to hold down Shift and we're going to drag it to the left, roughly about a distance that the motion path will allow for. And that means when the motion path starts, this whole text will be on the slide and then it will animate off to the left. And we can also see they're not perfectly aligned. So I'm just going to come up here to the Align tool. Now I don't want to align it to the slide. I want it to align to the objects, so I'll select that, then come back in here and align to the center. Much better. Now because we've already set the animation the way we want it on the first slide, we can copy that over to the second one. So I'll come here, select the text, go to Animations tab, and click Animation Painter. Then go to the second slide and click on Slide Intro. Beautiful. Now in this case, it hasn't got the outline one underneath, and that's okay, we'll fix that up in a moment. Now we don't want this motion path to come in from the bottom, so select this animation, come to Effect Options, and we want to change this to Right. And then come into Effect Options again, and reverse the path direction. There we go, and that's exactly what we want. I'll just drag this out of the way. I'll go to Animation Painter and I'll paint that same animation to the outline text as well. And I'll do that again for the awesome text. Perfect. Now for the awesome text, we don't want the letters to animate in. So we'll come in here, we'll just delete this animation. Great. And now we just need to make a few little changes to the others. Now I notice I have too many things called text to outline because silly me, I forgot to change the naming of that in the selection pane. So I'll do that now. I'll click on the slide intro, which is the solid one, and I'll just rename it here to solid and just get it in order. I'll drop it down over here. Now that makes a bit more sense. Now we want the outline to animate first. So I'm going to drag this animation to the top. And when I've done that, it drops it back to the start. So I've got the outline coming in first, followed by the solid animation, and then the motion paths as well. Now these motion paths are a bit long, so I'm going to hold down Shift and then select all three at the same time. And I'm going to decrease the duration to 1.25 seconds. I'll also come to Effect Options. And in this case, I want it to have a smooth end, which I'll set to 0.5 seconds. And I'll come back into Effect Options. And I'll get rid of the smooth start. Let's see what happens. Perfect. Now let's move this solid text back on top of the outline. You'll see where it's snapped in perfectly. I'll click here and let's just preview that. That looks fantastic. Now before we morph onto the next slide, I want to actually make this outline text disappear, because it makes the morph look a lot smoother. So to do that is I'll select this text, and again, I'll just add a third animation, which is disappear. and I want this to happen straight after the other animations finish. We're nearly done. So let's come to this second slide. We'll right click, we'll duplicate it. Now on this one, we don't need any animations at all. So let's delete them all. Select both sets of text. We're going to decrease the font size down to 80. We'll align it to the center of the slide. So click align to slide and click center. And then I'm going to move this slide intro up a bit. And as I said before, we don't need this outline, so I'm going to delete this. Now I want to make sure this is perfectly centered. So I'll select both sets of text, hold down Control G to group them, come up here and we'll select align to middle. And now we'll ungroup them so the morph works. So hold down Control Shift G and we're set to go. We also want to change the background color. So we'll right click, go to format background. We'll change the color of the background to white. Fantastic. Now there's only one more thing we need to do. We need to make sure all of our slides have the right transitions on them. Now the first two slides, we don't want any transition. So I'll select both by holding down Shift and selecting the second one. Come up to transitions, make sure that none is selected. We want these to animate automatically onto the next slide. So we'll click here in the after 0 seconds. We'll uncheck the on mask click. And we'll just come down to duration and just set it to the smallest we can. That will mean that this slide will transition to the next one straight after the animations. Then come to our third slide. And on this one, we want it to be a morph. So come to the morph transition. And we'll speed this up a bit to 0.75 seconds. And let's preview that again. Fantastic. So let's check that out. Now that's looking fantastic. And I'm pretty sure you probably get a job at Google now with those skills. And the great thing with this is once you've created it, you can come in and edit the text and you reuse this for as many sections or video intros that you need to. Well, I hope you learned something today with this video. And if you did, please click that like button for me as it really shows a lot of support to the channel and helps me grow. And if you'd like to see more videos like this, please subscribe to the channel and make sure that you don't miss any future videos. I've also included a download link in the description below. That's it for today. Thanks so much for watching. And for those who have subscribed to the channel, thank you for your support. I really appreciate it. See you next time.